Good morning. Hey, Vandella. Good morning, Tammy. Good morning, Vanessa. Good morning, Sandra Maria Rates and household. Sly Fox Run family crew. Bobby Jean, good morning. Good morning, Rosemary. Well, good morning, everyone. Before we begin service today, I just wanted to share a couple of crucial reminders. In this week, please be sure and prepare your U.S. Census data and mail that in. Also, remember, we must secure the vote. Mail your request for an absentee ballot to avoid the lines. And remember that next Sunday is Mother's Day. Treasure that relationship either live or in memory and do it throughout the month of May. And welcome to May. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter. Hallelujah. It is also Holy Communion Sunday. So I hope you have your elements of bread and juice or crackers ready for today's service. And remember, although you will take these elements at home, treat them with the same sacredness as if you were experiencing Holy Communion service during church time at Metropolitan. And now let us open with a word of prayer. Lord, every day we are awakened by you and we are blessed. Every time we share a smile or laugh with others, we celebrate you. You are our strength and our Redeemer. How can we possibly thank you for your holy nature? We do so by asking you to continuously share a smile with us as we seek to share a smile with others. We celebrate you, for you are our strength and you are our Redeemer. How can we possibly thank you for your holy nature? Amen. Please hear these words from the Old Testament, Psalm 23. I will be reading from the Contemporary English Version. You, Lord, are my shepherd. I will never be in need. You let me rest in fields of green grass. You lead me to streams of peaceful waters. And you refresh my life. You are true to your name, and you lead me along the right paths. I may walk through valleys as dark as death, but I won't be afraid, for you are with me, and your shepherd's rod makes me feel safe. You treat me to a feast with my enemies' watch. You honor me as your guest, and you fill my cup until it overflows. Your kindness and your love will always be with me each day of my life, and I will live forever in your house, O Lord. Amen. Amen. And then please hear these words from the New Testament. This is coming from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 42 through 47. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs that were performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common, and they sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had need. Every day they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes. They ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. The word of God for the people of God. And let us say together, thanks be to God. Let us pray. More of you, Lord, and less of me. For an abundance of blessings, for wisdom and grace, they fall fresh upon us like manna from heaven daily. We are grateful to serve you and to worship you, even in the midst of unknowns and in the midst of uncertainties. For the one who is lost, may we help guide them to you. For the one who is worldly and not of your spirit, we turn them over to you. Be a fixer in the valley and a balm of Gilead in these tumultuous moments in time. May we be less about ourselves and more about the broken world that surrounds us. For the one who fails to see their role in your plans, open their eyes to possibilities. For the one who thirsts is never satisfied, may they be quenched in you. For the one who waddles in the muck and mire of their polluted minds and hearts, heal their blackened souls. And as we await your second coming, may we all talk less and may we all do more. May our lives be living examples of your love, a love not perfected, but one that seeks to be available within our own human frailties. And may we count it a joy daily to celebrate you, to relish in the goodness of one another, and to count all things a glorious moment in the time that we are each given. Amen. I'd like you to hear these words from Psalm 23, and this is the traditional version, the King James Version. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Today's sermon title is The Lord Leadeth. The 23rd Psalm, or Psalm 23, is one of confidence and grants us the blessed assurance of God's care and God's goodness for his flock. The psalmist lets us know that he believes in a provisional God, a God that is one of restoration. Many of you may have heard of Pastor David Slagle. He once shared about a call that he had received from a girl in his department. And apparently her car had broken down and she was stranded approximately 2 miles from the office. So he decided to drive over and found her frustrated, leaning against her car. And he asked her what had happened. And she shared that she was simply driving down the road and the car quit running. So quite naturally, he asked her, did she run out of gas? She said that she had just filled the tank up. Slagle admits that it was about the extent of his car skills. But he decided to ask her something a little bit further. He asked her, did it make any noise? To which she responded, well, yeah. As I was driving down the hill, it went brum, 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 pow. Instinctually, Slagle asked her, when is the last time you changed the oil? And she gave him that same look I gave the person who asked me the same question when I had my first car. Oil? As it turned out, she had owned the car for approximately a year and a half, and she had never had her oil changed. Slagle shares, I get that same look when I ask frazzled friends, when was the last time you took a Sabbath rest? He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He refreshes, he restores my soul. He protects us from the valley of the shadow of death. And that is an actual road that can be walked in a day from Jericho to Jerusalem. It was known to be a dumping ground for dead bodies and where thieves would hide in caves to steal. As the Good Shepherd, we all know that he will protect us along this dangerous path that for us is life itself. And we further discover that we are cared for as a host cares for his guests. In ancient Israel, it was a custom to anoint your guests with oil. And at the end of Psalm 23, we are left with a perpetual hope as found in the promise of life eternal. Surely your goodness of love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. You see, we have a God that established all the ages. He is an omnipotent God. He is with us now and forevermore. We matter to him. We matter to God. Frank Capra, who directed It's a Wonderful Life, that movie that usually comes out during Christmas, was asked, he wanted to know, and people wanted to know, what was the central theme of his film? And after thinking for a few minutes, Capra actually stated that, I believe the real message of It's a Wonderful Life is that under the sun, nothing is insignificant to God. Now, when you watch the movie again, you know that everything that happens has intended and unintended consequences. Everything, because it happened, causes something else to happen. Everyone in that story is important because he or she relates with everyone else. Everyone else. We are all related. Nothing is insignificant under the sun to God. Perhaps we need ongoing assurances like Psalm 23 or the Lord's Prayer that not only are we important to God, but also that everyone around us is significant to God too. And it is when we place our faith in the God of the 23rd Psalm, we embrace for our lives what St. Patrick, the Irish missionary, and he was also a saint, what he once said, He said that God's mighty power directs me. God's power protects me. God's wisdom for learning. God's ears for hearing. God's word for my cleansing and clearing. You see, everyone, we serve a God who loves us and who sustains us at all times. And we are blessed that the psalmist David trusted him and found him to be true. And just like last week with doubting Thomas, even Christ shared, "Blessed is the one who believes and yet has not seen." Let us daily be a witness of the Good Shepherd on our path. Let us relish in the fact that we indeed have a God who ensures that we lack nothing, who causes us to rest and restores our souls, who guides us on the right path, who protects us on our darkest trails, who grants us comfort, who gives us the best, even in the presence of our enemies, the one who will never leave us or forsake us, who prepares a place for all of us who believe in the seat of eternity. By faith, we trust this God of Israel, and each of us should daily look for the appointed time when we will be in perfect union with him. Amen. And now we come to our communion service. I hope you have prepared your elements of juice, bread, or cup, or that you will take this sacred moment and immediately following the service, bring to remembrance the sacrificial lack of what it means to not know about our risen Savior who died on the cross for our sins and for our salvation. Before we break bread together, over two Fridays, I have been blessed by following a Zoom meeting. Well, actually, it's a Zoom service through Light of the Messiah Ministries of Atlanta. They have hosted weekly Shabbat meals. And the next one will actually be in 2 weeks or next week. And I will try to send out information on that. But a Shabbat meal is where Jewish believers, or those that believe, prepare a meal. And it occurs on Friday evening after sundown, and it's in preparation for the Sabbath. And the meal consists of bread, and it also consists of wine. Two candles are lit, and prayers are extended to God. And then the beauty of that evening is that following and during that service, there is shared conversation, usually with a rabbi or with a leader. And in those sacred moments, there are questions that are answered related to faith or about anything that's on the minds of believers. It is related to praxis and other key rituals. And there is always the shared wisdom of the collected group. Jesus would have participated in this meal. He would have been very familiar, especially with his apostles and his family. In those sacred Vesper moments of Sabbath preparation, there is a peace that floods into the soul of participants that I hope you too feel when you take Holy Communion. And so now let us prepare. Prepare our hearts, our minds, our spirit, and our souls for the sacrificial remembrance. As you uncover your communion elements, Let me remind you that you are all welcome. Anyone that is watching, all are welcome to the table. A table that is filled with sacrifice, with grace, with the mercy of God, with the love of God, with the grace, hope, peace, possibilities, and the gift of eternal life. Therefore, let us say together in our spirits as I read, lift up your hearts and give thanks to God. Blessed are you, O God, who with your word and Holy Spirit created all things and called them good. In Jesus Christ, your word became flesh and dwelt among us. Through Jesus' suffering and death, you took upon yourself our sin and death and destroyed their power forever. You raised from the dead this same Jesus, who now reigns with you in glory, and poured upon us your Holy Spirit, making us the people of your new covenant. For on the night before meeting with death, Jesus looked around the room at that scalawag group of fishermen, doctors, betrayers, all of the disciples and the apostles, and he said to them, tonight we take a special meal, and this meal will be done through the ages in memory of me, for my body will indeed be broken, and my blood will pour and water. So he took bread, he gave thanks to you, and he broke the bread, and he said to his disciples, take, eat. For this bread represents my body given for thee. In like manner, after he had broken the bread, he took the cup and he said to them, take ye and drink, for this cup represents my blood shed for thee. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, drink from this, all of you, for this is the blood of my new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts, that in the breaking of the bread and the drinking of this cup, we may know the presence of the living Christ. May we be renewed as the body of Christ for the world, redeemed by Christ's blood, until Christ comes again in final victory and we feast at your table forever. If you will now take your bread and break it and hold it. And now, if you would take your bread and either eat it, or you may wait until we're ready to dip it into the cup. But if you are holding your bread and you're prepared to eat it, take now and eat. And remember that this bread represents the body of Christ that was broken for thee. And now, take the cup that represents the blood of Christ that was shed for thee. Take ye and drink. through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And let us all say together, Amen. Let us now take this silent moment to make our personal petitions made known to God. Lord, we pray for all COVID-19 victims, for all healthcare workers, for those who are unwise in self-isolation, for those who are unclothed, unmasked, aren't properly prepared to walk this journey. Please give them wisdom and knowledge. Put someone in their path that can provide any needs that they have. And now let us say together the words we were taught to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Down the road, may you remember this sacred service during this pandemic season. What a blessing that in spite of our circumstances, we can still gather together and participate in a holy meal. That is what God is all about. That is who God is. That is what the Holy Spirit calls us to do. For God is in us, with us, surrounding us, working through us. This moment in time, as we always say, for such a time as this. Lord, we pray to you. We pray for one another. We pray for the world that is broken and is healed, and for your coming again. Each Sunday, everyone, we offer Christ to you because we believe in the resurrected Savior of the world. We rejoice in the good news that because he lives, we can face all of our tomorrows. We also invite you to let us know in the comment section where you are from and what we can do for you, not only during this season of pandemic, but in your life, whether you are seeking to know more for your life, or if you desire to grow stronger in your faith, or even if you desire to join with Metropolitan, you can do that right now. We can even pray for you if you want to give your life to Christ. But we also appreciate your tithes, your offerings, and your gifts. These help us to bridge the ministry of Christ with the world. You may mail your givings to us or online through the website under the Give tab. We are grateful that you have joined us on this fourth Sunday of Easter. May this new month present opportunities for all of us to draw closer to God. Remember, next Sunday is Mother's Day. Stay informed with us by connecting with our Facebook page or joining our email list. Feel free to share this broadcast or to follow us on YouTube. And now, let us prepare to receive the benediction. In your joy and in your sorrow, in your plenty and in your need, in your going out and in your coming in, may you believe in God the Father. May you believe in our risen Lord and Savior. And may the Holy Spirit that dwells with us now May it richly bless you, now and forevermore, until we meet again. Thanks be to God. Amen. My prayer is that everyone will be safe as we continue to move into a season where states are opening up, where there's a lot of unrest in the world. We simply ask that you stay centered and that you stay focused on what matters most, and that's our personal and collective relationship with God. Blessings in your day. Know that you are loved by me, that you're prayed for. You know I keep my prayer journal, and that we will get through this. We will get through this. Not only one day at a time, but one second at a time. For God is indeed able, and God is good. Always remember that. Thank you for tuning in. Have a blessed day and an even powerful week. In his name we pray. Amen. Bye, everyone. Got to get back to my praise music. Love you all. Be safe and be good. Bye-bye.